Hello everyone. Today I am solving some more problems on impact of jet. I hope you have watched my previous video. The second problem I am solving now. First I'll read this problem. A jet of water of diameter 50 mm, it means D, having a velocity of 20 meter per second. So jet velocity is 20 meter. This V strikes a curved vane which is moving with the velocity 10 meter per second, that is u, in the direction of jet. See, jet is striking the direction of the moving vane, right? So it means here jet is striking here means vane direction, both directions are same. So at inlet the jet is acting now or striking horizontally, understood? The vane leaves, the jet leaves the vane at an angle 60 degree to the direction of motion of the vane at outlet. It means the jet leaves, it means V2 is making an angle 60 degree with respect to horizontal at outlet. We have to find out what the force exerted. So Fx is equal to, in the direction of motion, it is Fx. Work done per second by the jet is Fx into u. Once the given diameter of the jet, we can find out the area, pi d square by 4. Jet velocity is given, vane velocity is given, jet leaving, no, it means V2, direction is given, we can find out Fx. What is Fx? So rho Fx is equal to force is equal to rho A Vr1 into Vw1 plus or minus Vw2. What is work done? Fx into u. The given jet is acting in the direction of moving vane. That is alpha is equal to 0. Okay. This is. It means this is, look at this. This is the velocity triangle at inlet. Since alpha becomes 0, B joins to D. So AB is equal to AD is equal to V1 is equal to VW1. Here U1, AC represents U1. See, I have marked here U1. CB is equal to CD is equal to VR1. Okay, see, look at here. Now, this is a diagram, line diagram I have written. So, V2 is the given. How to write V, result component of V2? VF1, VF2, and VW2. Okay, draw vertical line. Horizontal line. Vr2 always will act on the left side. This will act at an angle phi. Okay. So now I'll explain you about how to solve this. When the jet strikes horizontal here, V1 is equal to Vw1. They given the value 20 meter per second. U1 also they given is 10 meter per second. Can you calculate Vr1? Vr1 is equal to V1 minus U1 is equal to 10 meter per second. Okay. So here nothing is mentioned about vane is symmetric, etc. But we will take it as U1 is equal to U2 is equal to U. It means vane velocity at inlet, outlet are same. It is 10 meter per second. Okay. Vane is smooth. We are considering VR1 is equal to VR2. Okay. So once inlet is over, then we have to consider it outlet. So jet is moving, no, leaving the vane at an angle 60 degree. So this is 60 degree. Draw a line here. It has, that angle is equal to 60 degree. So total angle is 180 degree at junction H. So beta you can calculate how? 180 minus 60. Okay, beta, which is more than now 90 degree. Okay, so next. Vr2 always will be on the left side, I told you, right? So this angle, water always leaves, or it means the relative velocity after striking, right? Now the water which is going out, that velocity is equal to relative velocity, will go out with the velocity, with the angle is equal to vane angle at outlet, this is phi. So this is phi, this angle also phi. Okay. What is the center angle, the angle between G and EH, that is total angle at junction E is 180 degree, right? So this angle is 180 minus 60 minus 5. So that is 120 minus 5. Okay, now I'll use sine rule for the triangle GEH. Okay, so it is VR2 divided by sine 60 is equal to, see this side, V2 divided by sine 120 minus 5 is equal to, okay, V2 divided by sine 5. Okay, see, substitute VR2 you know, U2 we know, we don't know V2, right? 5 also we don't know. So consider any two terms of the equation. So here only one is unknown. I'll consider this as equation number 1. Consider equation now 1. Cross multiply. So sine 120 minus 5 is equal to 10 into sine 60 divided by 10. So 120 minus 5 is equal to sine inverse of this value. So 5 is equal to 60 degree. So if at all absolute velocity is asked in the question, you have to find out V2. Okay, by considering the equation. Okay, now I am not doing that because velocity, absolute velocity at outlet is not asked in the question. They asked, solve it. Otherwise, what is required, that one you have to find out. Our intention is to find out VW2 and VW1, right? VW1 already over, next one is VW2. Why? To find out the force and work done. So what I'll do here, look at this. So I know this. VR2, I know this side. Okay. So GE is equal to U2 minus VW2. So what I'll do, cos phi is equal to U2 minus VW2 divided by VR2. Okay. So that I'll apply here. So we'll substitute all the values which are known. So VW2 is equal to 10 cos 60 minus here this. I'll take this term to here. So VW2 will become plus here. This term will become minus. So the final answer is VW2 is equal to 5 meter per second. Next, the force exerted by the jet. That is rho A VR1 into VW1 minus her. I'm writing here because beta is more than 90 degree. So VW2. Substitute all the values. You will get Fx. Work done equal to Fx into U. Okay, substitute. You will get in watts or newton meter per second. What all power they asked? Very simple. Fx into U divided by 1000. So we will solve one more problem here. A jet of water having a velocity of 20 meter per second. What is that? V. Strikes a curved vane which is moving with the velocity of 10 meter per second. Understood? 10 meter per second. The jet, it means U. Jet makes an angle of 20 degree with the direction of motion of the vane at inlet. The jet makes an angle 20 degree, what is that, alpha, with respect to direction of motion, means the horizontal line. Okay, that is, this looks like this, and leaves at an angle 130 degree. So what is that? Water leaves at an angle 130 degree. Okay, in the direction of motion. Okay, calculate vane angles. What are the vane angles? Theta and phi. Theta at inlet, phi at outlet. So that water enters and leaves the vane without shock. What is that? VR1 is equal to VR2. Work done per second per unit weight of water striking. So that is VW1 plus or minus VW2 into U divided by G. So rho A VR1 get cancels. Okay, first write down what are the data they have given. Okay, the jet striking angle at the inlet they given, leaving angle at outlet they given. So now your work is to draw velocity triangle. Okay, so this is the triangle they given, 130 degree at outlet, inlet. How to draw velocity triangle? So first you have to write the resolved component of V1, that is VF1 and VW1, okay, VW1, vertical, the perpendicular line. Okay, next you have to draw a line, that is here A We'll take it as A, this as B, A, B, C represents V R 1. V R 1 is relative velocity at inlet. So B, D represents V F 1. Okay. So next, at outlet, V 2 is here, right? The result component of V 2 are vertical direction, it is perpendicular line to right, V F 2 in the line V 2. So here to here is V 2. Next, draw V R 2 always on the left side, that is V R 2. Okay, name it as E here. You can see here E G F H. So V 2 always will make an angle beta with respect to the direction of motion. V R 1, okay, what are leaving it, and then angle is equal to vein angle at outlet. You can see here everything clearly have written. Okay, now they have given V2 is making an angle 130 degree. You know this angle is phi. So what is this angle? Alternate angle, no? This is equal to beta. What is this angle then? Beta minus phi. Okay. So this is completed velocity triangle. But now I'll consider velocity triangle at a inlet. Okay. So they given alpha, they given V1, they given E1. So you can see now the right mark, these data they have given. Okay. I want VW1, right? Why we want? See, look at the question. Work done. Work done is VW1, VW2 we require. So cos alpha is equal to, in this triangle, what is cos alpha? VW1 divided by V1. Find out V1. What is sin alpha? Sin alpha is equal to Vf1 divided by V1. Why I am finding Vf1 here, you know? Because I want the angle phi here. Okay? We want Vr1 also. So, this triangle, if I find Vf1, I can calculate what is the angle. Because this side by this side. Look at here. Tan theta is equal to, right? This triangle. You know Vf2. I know VW1. I can calculate the CD is equal to VW1 minus U1, right? Okay. So tan theta is equal to VF1 by CD. That is, we can find out what is the angle theta. Okay, just substitution. Now, we want to find VR1. I told you always inlet velocity triangle, we have to find VR1 because that is a VR1 is equal to VR2. So that we can solve this outlet triangle. Now, Vr1, because Vr1 is equal to Vr2. Theta is known, right? Apply sine rule. Or in a triangle ABC, you can see here, ABC, or we can do, we consider a triangle BCD. Can you see here BCD? BCD. Sin phi is equal to, because we want this, right? We want this. You can do two ways, right? You can do Pythagoras theorem. So, this BD square plus CD square is equal to square root of this. You can calculate. Or tan theta. Tan is equal to VF2 divided by this side. Because this is perpendicular. So, we have found here VR1. VR1 is equal to VR2. Now, consider the outlet velocity triangles. Have written here. Okay, this total angle is beta. This angle is phi. Central angle is beta minus phi. Okay, this angle is 130 degree. So you can find out beta. This angle is 130 degree. This is beta. Can you calculate beta? 180 minus 130. Right? 180 minus 130. So what is beta? Beta is 50 degree. No, beta plus 130 is more less than 90 degree. So we know beta, we know beta here, we know VR1, VR2, U2, etc. Now apply sine rule in G, E, F, this triangle. Okay, so G is VR2 divided by, can you calculate this angle? This angle? Yeah, this angle is 130 degree, right? this angle is 130 degree, even this also 130 degree. Okay, so VR2 divided by sine 180 minus beta is 130 degree, right? It is. Next is equal to GF. GF, this side divided by sine beta minus phi is equal to FE. FE, that is V2 divided by sine phi. Okay, just substitute the values, what are known. Okay, just substitute, you will get. So, 11 point, VR2 is 11.14 divided by sine 130 is equal to 10 divided by beta is 50 minus 5 is equal to V2 divided by sine 5. Okay, here if I am not considering this as first equation because two are unknown. I'll consider this here, only one is unknown. So, find out, cross multiply here, find out sine 50 minus 5 is equal to, okay. Substitution value 0.6876. So phi is equal to, you can calculate 50 minus this angle, that is 43.44, that is 6.56 degree. Okay, now so outlet vane angle over, inlet vane angle also over. Next is to now find out the work done. See, we want what? VW2. So, how to find out VW2? Okay, that is the question here. So now, VW2 is unknown. Here, the triangle, in this triangle, you know, U2 you know, VR2 you know, phi you know. So, with this, substitute cos phi is equal to U2 plus VW2. This is the side divided by hypotenuse. So we will get VW2 is equal to 1.067 after the substitution. So what do we want work done? Per second per unit weight of water is VW1 plus or minus VW2 into U divided by G. Here I am using plus sign because beta is less than 90 degree. Substitute, you will get Newton meter per Newton or watts. Okay, so homework, just do it. Yeah, just I'll read it. I'll give the hint. I have written here also. You can go through this. A jet of water having a velocity of 40 meter per second. What is that? V. V is given. Strikes the curved vane, which is moving with the velocity. What is that? U. Okay, the jet moves at an angle 30 degree with the direction of motion of the vane at inlet. What is that? Alpha is 30 degree and leaves at an angle 90 degree at outlet. Can you see here? Leaves an angle 90 degree at outlet. So what is this here? Beta also you can calculate. No, V2 is making an angle 90 degree. So beta also will be 90 degree. So V2 will be equal to VF2. Next, draw the velocity triangle at inlet and outlet and determine the vane angles. It means theta and phi are to be calculated. Here, take water. Okay, water enters and leaves without shock. It means VR1 is equal to VR2. Okay, sample velocity diagrams I have given here. Solve this.